Good morning, children. In yesterday's class, have you completed page 173? All the exercise. Have you drawn that leaf? See, many of you have drawn the leaf, but not properly. See my video, pause it, and try to draw with light pencil. Then you can color it, and you have to label the parts. So once again, you have to draw it and practice it, children. Now, have you received your question copy, children? Isn't it? Receive no? Very good. Have you prepared for the test? In today's class, what we will do? We will completely revise plant life from page number 166 to 173. All the exercise from textbook as well as from the notebook. The extra question answers also what I have given, we will read it for test. So before we open the textbook and do revision, what you have to do? You do your homework. Your homework is prepare yourself for test. Now you are attending 3 weekly test, isn't it? So prepare for test page number 166 to 173. It's all about plant life. Plant life. And the exercise which is given on page 173 and the middle question and answer and the word meanings. We will open the textbook and notebook and we will revise it. So open your textbook, page number 163.
See children, open page 166. Here they have shown all types of plants. Trees, herbs, shrubs, creepers, climbers. So here let us read this. Look at the different kinds of plants in the above picture. Read the following questions. Tick the answer that you think is right. What is common in all these plants? All the plants have bright colorful flowers. Wrong. All the plants have green leaves. So for the first one, answer number 2 is correct. Question number 2. How many plants have thick woody stems? First one, all plants have thick woody stems. Wrong. 4 plants have thick woody stems. Correct. Which plant is creeping on the ground? A. The plant which has very small leaves is creeping on the ground. Wrong. The plant which has very thin stem is creeping on the ground. Right. Now come to page number 167. From this part I have given you some questions that also we will learn. And this part already you have written in your textbook that you have to complete it. And you have to practice this plant and you have to label the parts. So now coming to page number 160. From this you have learnt about 2 types of roots, taproot and fibrous root. So this question answers we will learn from the notebook. Here one more question is there. Carrot, radish and beetroot are tap roots. Why they are thick and swollen? This also we will read from the notebook. Next one. Why is the root important to the plant? Answer. Root is important to the plant because it gives support to the plant. Second one, it absorbs water and minerals from the soil. This is from page number 168. Come to page, next page. See children, here we have learned how to draw the leaf. See how the leaf is given here and how you are drawing. You are not drawing properly. So see this textbook, refer it and practice this for your test. Okay, see what is this? This is the leaf margin. This is the leaf blade. This is midrib or main vein. This is the main vein middle. This is the leaf stalk. These are veins of a leaf. This you have to prepare it. See here they have given different questions. Here find out the difference uses of coconut leaves. This from the notebook we will learn. Here 3 leaves that you can eat raw. Spinach, mint, tulsi and coriander. Come to next page. Here see children. About fruits and seeds. Here they have given some question. Name some fruits that have only one seed. Already I have given you these answers also. We will read it now. After that, one more question is there. What do we get from plants? This also we will learn from the notebook. Now come to page number 173. See children, from page number 172, they have given which part of the plant do we eat. Match the plant in column A with its part in column B. Yesterday I have told you that you have to complete your test book also, page number 172 and 173. So see here, spinach leaf, wheat seed, onion stem, radish root, apple fruit. Okay, question number 2, don't by heart it. Now come to the next exercise, page number 173. See here, fill in the blanks with the correct alternative. The roots of a plant grow below the ground. The stem grows above the ground. Creepers have weak stems. Most trees live for many years. The rice plant is a herb. Come to question number 4. Name the following. The process through which plants prepare their food. Photosynthesis. The green substance present in the leaves. Chlorophyll. The flat broad portion of the leaf. Leaf blade. The roots which store food in them. Carrot and radish. Now come to question number 5. Tick the statements that are true and cross the wrong ones. All plants have tap roots. Wrong. Garlic is a stem. Right. The stem absorbs water and minerals from the soil. Right. Plants which have narrow weak stem and need support to grow are called herbs. Wrong. Popcorn is made from the seeds of the maize plant. Right. Here you have to draw a pepper leaf and these you have to label it from page number 170. Okay children, once again draw this and send it back to me. And you have to prepare for the test. Now we will open the notebook and read question which is related to the plant life. See, what are trees? Trees are tall plants with thick, strong and woody stems are called trees. Name 5 trees. Neem tree, banyan tree, mango tree, gulmohar tree and balsam. Name 3 shrubs. Rose, jasmine, show flower. What are herbs? Plants which have small and soft stems are called herbs. Example, wheat, grass, mint and coriander. To fifth one, what are climbers? Plants which have narrow stems and need support to climb are called climbers. Example, money plant and grapevine. What are creepers? Plants which have narrow and weak stem. They bear big and heavy fruits are called creepers. Example, pumpkin and watermelon. Now come to the next question and answer. That is, what is a root? What are roots? The parts which grow under the ground are called roots. Name the types of roots. The types of roots are taproot and fibrous root. What is taproot? Plants with one main and inner roots is a taproot. These roots grow deep into the soil, for example, carrot, radish, turnip and beetroot. What are fibrous root? Plants don't have a main root. They have a bunch of small roots are called fibrous roots. For example, grasses, wheat and coconut tree. See the next one. Why are carrot, radish and beetroot thick and swollen? Carrot, radish and beetroot are swollen taproot as they store food which is edible. Why is root important to the plant? Root is important to the plant because it gives support to the plant. It absorbs water and minerals from the soil. See the next one. What is a leaf? A leaf is a green part of a plant or a tree. What is chlorophyll? The green substance present in plants are known as chlorophyll. What is photosynthesis? The process by which green plants and some other organism use sunlight to synthesize nutrients from carbon dioxide and water is called photosynthesis. Why are leaves mostly green in color? Answer is, leaves are mostly green in color due to the presence of the green pigment called chlorophyll. See the next question. What is a flower? The colored part of a plant from which fruit grow is a flower. What is pollination? Pollination is the act of transferring pollen grains from the male anther of a flower to the female. Name some fruits that have only one seed. dates, cherries, mango and lychee. Name some fruits that have many seeds. Custard apple, papaya, watermelon, muskmelon, chiku. Can you think of a fruit that has no seeds? Banana and pineapple. See, what do we get from plants? Answer is, plant gives us shade. Plant help us to keep a place cool. Plants bring in more rain. Plants release oxygen, which we breathe. Plants provide us with food, fiber, shelter, medicine and fuel. And one, two more questions we will read. See, leaves are known as the food factory of the plant. Leaves are known as the food factory of the plant because it makes food by the process of photosynthesis with the help of raw materials like water and carbon dioxide using sunlight and chlorophyll. The next question is, three leaves that you can eat raw: spinach, mint and coriander. Last one, find out the different uses of coconut leaves. Articles that can be made from coconut leaves include fans, baskets, fancy belts, brooms, mats and hangings. So children, you have to prepare all these question and answers and do attend the test, and the next day send your scored marks. Okay children, have a nice time. Bye.